The Silures were a powerful Celtic tribe that inhabited the lands of southeast Wales during the time of the Roman invasion of Wales. They were fierce and warlike and resisted Roman conquest. Originally, this Celtic tribe may have had their roots in Spain before settling in Wales. As the Roman historian Tacitus wrote, the swarthy faces of the Silures, the curly quality in general of their hair, and the position of Spain opposite their shores, attest to the passage of Iberians in old days and the occupation by them of these districts. Silures is a Latin word with a Celtic origin, perhaps from the Celtic root silo, meaning seed. This may suggest that Silures meant kindred or stock, although some have interpreted the name in a more practical sense, with it potentially meaning rich in grain. As opposed to a centralised tribe, the Silures can perhaps be thought of as more of a confederation of smaller tribes that lived in the area and were bound by similar cultural traits. These traits allowed them to unify in times of crisis. In line with other Celtic groups, the Silures' base of operations and capital was a hill fort, thought to be the town of Llan Melyn. In the initial period of resistance to Roman conquest, the Silures were led by Caractacus, or Caradoc as they say in Wales, the king of the Trinovantes tribe of the area around Essex in eastern England. Caractacus had fled to Wales to stir up resistance after some initial defeats against the Romans in England. He became a military leader of the Silures before moving on to lead another Welsh tribe who opposed Roman conquest, the Ordovices tribe of northern Wales, but more on them in a future video. After Caractacus left, the Silures continued to resist Roman rule, using guerrilla warfare tactics effectively. They were such a nuisance to Rome that the Roman governor of Britain, Publius Ostorius Scapula, called for the Silures to be exterminated or transplanted. On one occasion, the Celtic tribe surrounded and attacked a Roman legionary unit that was building Roman forts in their territory. The Romans were only rescued by additional Roman forces, but there was heavy casualties suffered by the Romans. When Ostorius died in 52 AD, the Silures were far from conquered. The Celtic tribe seemed steadfast in their desire for independence and autonomy. As Tacitus wrote, the Silures were changed neither by cruelty nor clemency. One practice the Silures engaged in was taking Roman soldiers as hostages and handing them out amongst various smaller tribal units amongst them. This was done to improve morale and further encourage resistance. The Silures are finally thought to have been defeated in around 78 AD after campaigns led by the Roman leader Sextus Julius Frontinus. Whether the Silures were defeated or decided to sue for an agreement is not clear. The Romans eventually managed to establish a Roman fortress in Isca, Caerleon, which is just north of Newport in modern Wales. A Roman amphitheatre is still visible today in Caerleon. The territory of the Silures and Wales in general was annexed into the Roman Empire and was under Roman control for centuries. The capital of the Silures became Caerwent during this period, with Roman walls still present in the village today. Excavations have revealed a Roman forum, an amphitheatre, and Roman baths in the village. Despite the Roman influence, the history of the Silures still lives on today. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and hit the bell to turn on notifications. You can also support this work through buymeacoffee.com and Patreon. All the links are in the description below. Thanks again. Speak to you next time.